Welcome back, and if everything's worked as expected, you should see 5 create complete stacks within the CloudFormation console. You should have your parent stack and then a total of 4 nested stacks. One for the on-premises VPC, one for the AWS VPC, one for the on-premises self-managed Active Directory, and then one for the on-premises compute. Now, in this stage of the demo lesson, we're going to configure our access to the on-premises network, and we're going to do that via the jump box. Now, the way that this is done depends on the operating system that you're using. For Windows, it includes a built-in remote desktop application, and you can use that to connect through to the jump box. For macOS, you'll need to download the official Microsoft Remote Desktop application, and the instructions on how to do this are contained in this stage's instructions on the GitHub repository and also attached to this lesson. For Linux, there are a range of third-party remote desktop applications, and you'll need to download and install one of those on your chosen operating system distribution in order to continue. Whichever option you pick, we need to obtain the details that we'll use to connect into the jump box. So to do that, go to Services, locate EC2. If you can't see it, you can always type it in this search box and then open that in a new tab. Once you're at the EC2 console, just go ahead and click on Instances, and you'll see a total of 5 instances that have been created as part of CloudFormation setting up this infrastructure. And the one that we're interested in at this point is the jump box. So go ahead and select the jump box EC2 instance. Once you've selected it, we need the public DNS IP version 4 address. So this is the host name or the DNS name that we'll use to connect into this jump box. So you'll need to note down this DNS name and just note down that it refers to the on-premises jump box, because that will make it easier to refer to as we move through this demo lesson. Now, I'm using macOS, and so I'm using the official Microsoft Remote Desktop application. So in order to connect to this jump box, first I need to make sure that I've got the PC section selected and then click on Add PC. Now, the exact way you do this will depend on the application, but it's fairly common to have a box for the hostname or the IP address and then a friendly name for the connection. So for the hostname or the IP address, you need to paste in the DNS name for the jump box. If you do have the option to pick a friendly name or a name for the connection, then do that. If you're using the official Microsoft Remote Desktop application, then you'll need to just enter the DNS name in the box and then go ahead and connect. Because this is macOS, I'm just going to go ahead and click on Add. And that adds a connection to the on-premises jump box. Now, to get the details that you'll need to connect to this instance, because remember we'll need a username and a password, right-click on the entry for jump box and click on Connect. Now, the username that you'll need is administrator, and to get the password, you'll need the SSH key that you downloaded in the earlier stage of the demo. To do that, click on RDP client and then scroll down and click on Get Password. Go ahead and click on Upload Private Key File and then select the PEM file that you created and downloaded in the previous stage of the demo. In my case, it's a4l.pem. So select that, this box should populate with the contents of this PEM file, and then go ahead and click on Decrypt Password. And that will give you the administrator password for this jump box EC2 instance, and you'll need to copy that into your clipboard. Once you've got that password, if you're using macOS, we can just go ahead and double click on this entry. If you're using Windows, you should already see a username and password box if you've entered the DNS name of the jump box and gone ahead and connected. In either case, enter administrator for the username and then paste in the password for this EC2 instance. And then connect. You might have to answer some form of security prompt. If you do, then click whichever option continues the process. After a few seconds, it should log you in, and you might see a personalized settings dialog pop up briefly, but after anywhere from a couple of seconds up to a minute, you should be placed at the Windows desktop. You might see a networks dialog. Just go ahead and answer yes to this. That's not relevant to the demo, but that will dismiss that dialog. But now you're connected to the on-premises jump box as part of this demo lesson. Now, if we take a look at the architecture diagram, you'll see that the on-premises network consists of two domain controllers, DC1 and DC2, a file server, logically called file server, and then a fourth server called client. And the client server is going to be the one that you're going to be doing most of the on-premises work from. It's designed to simulate an on-premises virtual desktop. So we need to connect into the client server. Now, to do that, we need to move back to the AWS console and get the internal IP address of this client machine. Now, to make things quicker at this point, what I suggest is that you get the private IP address for each of these servers. So do it in turn. Start with DC1 and note down the private IP address for DC1. Then go ahead and do the same for DC2. That will be a different private IP address. And don't be concerned if both of these match the IP addresses that I have in your environment. Once you've done that, go ahead and do the same for file server. You might have a different IP address for file server than me, that's okay. And then finally, go ahead and do the same for client. Again, you might have a different IP address, but you'll need to copy down this IP address into your clipboard. Once you've got that, move back to the jump box, click on the start button, and then start typing remote for remote desktop, and click on the remote desktop connection icon. This is the Windows remote desktop client. If you're running this on your local machine, it should look familiar. And what we're going to do now is connect from the jump box to the client server, which remember is the simulated virtual desktop product running within our on-premises environment. So we need to paste in the IP address of the client server. So let's do that, paste that in, and then click on connect. Now you'll be asked to enter your credentials, and this client machine has been joined to the on-premises Active Directory domain. So the Active Directory domain running on-premises is ad.animalsforlife.org. So we want to connect into the client machine using an Active Directory username and password. So to do that, we're going to connect in using an admin user. So admin at and then ad.animalsforlife.org. Now the password will be the domain admin password that you picked when provisioning the CloudFormation infrastructure. So go ahead and enter that. In real world production usage, you would not be using an administrator user, but to keep this demo simple, we're going to stick to the single user, but nothing that we do will change if you have lots of different users. It just keeps it nice and simple and makes the demo as quick and efficient as possible. So go ahead and enter the admin password that you selected when creating the CloudFormation infrastructure and select OK. Again, you might receive a security dialog. Just go ahead and click to bypass that, and then you'll be connected into the client instance. And remember, this simulates a virtual desktop running within the on-premises environment of the Animals for Life organization. Again, you might find that that takes a few seconds to connect, but once it has, you should see a Windows desktop. So at this point, we're connected into the simulated on-premises environment of the Animals for Life organization. We're connected to a simulated virtual desktop that we want to migrate into AWS, and we also need to migrate the file server that the organization uses. To access the file server, go ahead and click on Windows Explorer on the bar at the bottom, and then in this entry field, just go ahead and type /, and then file server, all one word, and press enter. You'll be taken to the file server, and you'll be able to see that there's a share called A4L files. Go ahead and enter that file share, and we're going to create a demo file on this file share that we want to migrate into the AWS environment. Now, obviously, if this is in production, it would be lots more files and folders, but for the purpose of this demo, we can use the same techniques whether we have one file or a million. So just right-click, go to New, and then create a text document. We're going to call this text document whatanimalsarethebest.txt. So go ahead and enter that. Open that text file, and inside it, enter a list of whichever animals you think are the best. So for me, it will be cats, of course, and then a few exclamation marks for effect. Save that document and exit out. So at this point, we have a file server a file share on that file server, and a file inside that we're going to migrate. What we also have is an on-premises self-managed Active Directory. To demonstrate that, click on the Start button, go to Windows Administrative Tools, and locate Active Directory Users and Computers, and just open up that application. We'll just maximize it to make it easier to see. You'll see at the top we've got the ad.animalsforlife.org Active Directory domain. If we go inside there, select Users, you'll be able to see the admin user that we've got that's been created. If we expand Computers, you can see Client, which is the machine that we're connected to, File Server, which is the file server that hosts that file share, and then inside Domain Controllers, we have DC1 and DC2. All of these are running inside the simulated on-premises environment, but this is a fully self-managed Microsoft Active Directory running on Windows Server. Now at this point, you've completed stage 2 of this demo lesson. You've now got access to the on-premises environment and verified that everything's functioning as expected. You've browsed to the file share A4L files that's running on the file server, and you've created a file. Now, during the upcoming stages of this demo lesson, we're going to be provisioning the hybrid environment and migrating segments of this on-premises infrastructure into AWS step by step. In the next stage of this demo lesson, which is stage 3, you're going to be creating the managed Microsoft Active Directory running inside the directory service in AWS, and this is the directory service instance that we're going to be configuring with a two-way trust later in this demo series. So the next step is to create the Microsoft managed Active Directory running with the directory service inside AWS. But at this point, you've completed all of the steps for stage 2 of this demo lesson. So go ahead, complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in stage 3.